A wee rascal. Thanks for that, Jean. Hey, little fella, you sit by that barrel now. Hello, you malt mega limericks. Ralphie here, whisky review 126, the concluding vlog on a wee run of Irish whiskies. But before we get to the whiskies, how about the limericks? Well, limericks are a short poem of two rhyming couplets and a punchline. That's what a limerick is. And it is believed that the limerick was invented to entertain soldiers as they marched home from France to Limerick in Ireland in the 1700s. Now, what can I say about a limerick? Well, the limerick is callous and crude. Its morals distressingly lewd. It's not worth the reading by persons of breeding. No, it's designed to be vulgar and rude. The limerick packs laughs anatomical. It does. Into space that's quite economical. But the good ones I've seen are seldom clean. And the clean ones seldom comical. So there you have it. That's limericks for you. This is not a limerick. This is Connemara single malt Irish whiskey. Now, it's not your usual Irish malt, this one. It is not triple distilled. And it is not what you would call light. Not by a long chalk. I shall pour a glass to demonstrate this. Lovely. Oh, that looks like a natural coloured whisky. Yes, and it's bottled at 46%. And it's a single cask Connemara. It was bottled in 2006, which at the time of recording this vlog is 4 years ago. And I have had this bottle in a shelf in the cupboard for 4 years because I tend to buy whiskies as and when they're around at a reasonable price, and I put them aside, not for next week, next month, or even next year, but I put them aside for 5, 10, even 15 years down the line. And when I open the bottle, I know that they will no longer be out there, no longer available. And if they are of good quality, which they will be, having been hand-picked, they'll probably be pretty damn expensive in any currency. So this is a bottle that I bought a while back. And there are more updated Connemaras out there with different influences. Mainly American bourbon cask, but also sherry, port, and of varying ages as well. They're worth looking out for. As I say, they are peated Irish whiskies. And the big question that you malty heads will be asking is, well, Ralphie, how do they compare to Islay? Well, bearing in mind that this distillery, Cooley, is nearer to Islay than Speyside, there is certainly quite a lot in common, and I would certainly prefer a peated Irish whiskey over most of the Speyside peated whiskies. Of course, there's no point in saying this is good as our Beg, a Lagavulin, or a quarter cask Laphroaig, because it's not that style. You don't have the huge phenolic peaty notes that you get with Laphroaig and Lagavulin. You don't have the big iodine kick that you get with Laphroaig, or the burning ashes, embers and leaves that you get with Cooleela. What you get with Connemara is something initially sweeter, but measured, fruity, I would say delicate, but intensely delicate. Delicate with intensity. It's a delightful honeyed nose. White fruits. There's white grapes. There's a touch of rhubarb here. There's a delicious hay, grassy, summer's day type barley nature to this. And in amongst it, not cutting through, not imposing itself, but going hand in hand with this Irish barley is the peat. And the peat is intriguing. It's almost like it's got a different character to your Scotch whiskies. A different relationship between the peat and the whisky. The nearest distillery in Scotland I would equate it to is actually Ardmore, which funnily enough is right in the borders of Speyside and was one of the more accomplished peated Speyside whiskies. This has got a superb engaging nose, helped of course by the presentation, higher strength, less chill filtration. That's had a wee bit of water after I've tasted it. I've really enjoyed this run of Irish whiskies, which tend to be looked down upon by Scotch whisky fans and malt snobs. The problem with Irish whisky is that there's only basically two points of reference for the majority of whisky drinkers: Jameson's and Bushmills, but they don't tell the whole story. These are corporate multinational distilleries. They present the whisky at 40% with caramel added and chill filtered, and in doing so they take a more delicate style of whisky, which can have an intrinsic complexity, and they dampen it down with the presentation. It makes the whisky smooth but a little bit featureless if you don't give it time. Cooley, big thumbs up to Cooley, because as an independent whisky distiller in Ireland, they really do sound a fanfare for the future of Irish whisky. Now, times are hard in Ireland at the moment. Tough times with the economy. So it's never been a better time to set up a little distillery in Ireland. And if you pick the right place, you pick the right people to work it, you're going to have a winner, because Irish whiskey can be fantastic, absolutely. So good luck to Dingle if you go to Dublin and head down to the west coast, to the most westerly point. You come through Tralee and you head on west to Dingle. The little distillery is going to be opened up there, so we wish them all the best. But Connemara, taste. There's an intensity, kind of Auchentoshan Bowmore Ardmore thing, a delicious sourness. The peat allows the malt itself, the barley, to make the running, and it follows up behind, more gentle, but while still retaining an intensity. Marks out of 100. 14 years old, so a good age for a peated whisky. You still get the freshness of the peat going on. 88 out of 100. And that, my malty mates, is of course a malt mark. So don't be too snobby about your whiskies. It's one of the great things that you learn about whiskies is when you go outside your comfort zone and try something else. Now and again, take a chance. And like myself, you'll come across these Irish whiskies. They're well worth finding. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye, Jean. Say goodbye to Jean. He's away home now.